Hey folks, welcome back to the channel. Thanks for joining me today. Now, today, quick video. I just wanted to talk about some gear that I'd procured recently. It is audio related, but a bit more on the camera side of things, so just bear with me on that one. I'm so excited about it, I felt like I had to tell somebody. So, the audio for recording these types of videos, and in fact, any videos, for a long time I'd tried shotgun mics. Now, first off, I started with this, which is the Comica VM30. Now, the way this works is you have your shotgun mic with camera gain on it, and you have a receiver. It's wireless, right? So you take your jack cable out of the receiver, wherever that goes, out of the receiver, into the camera. And this worked okay, not bad. Kind of useful, some might say. And so that's how that looks. And also there was, in the pack, you get a mount for the top of the camera. So as I say, this one was pretty useful. However, the quality of it is, it's okay. But with me being a bit of a perfectionist, I was always looking for improvement. So next I decided to run with the big boys and get a Sennheiser MKH416. And this is what I've been using for the longest time. Now, this was not cheap, but it sounds absolutely phenomenal, right? It really, really does sound great. Obviously, the camera doesn't have phantom power on it, and this mic needs phantom power with it being a condenser. So then I went down the road of buying an external preamp, and I bought this, the Tascam 60D Mark II. Fancy, can sit on the camera, can sit elsewhere, does preamp-like things, right? And it supplies 48 volt. And I thought, this setup, excellent. And I started to get some pretty good results from it. However, we did run into another problem. And that problem is, or was, the preamp on the camera, because you always have to run into the camera preamp, regardless of if you use an external preamp or not, you still have to run the audio into the camera through its preamp. And the issue I had is the preamp inside the camera is absolutely garbage. It's very, very noisy. Now, that Sennheiser, don't get me wrong, right? This is a beautiful microphone, but it's very sensitive. And so I found that it used to pick up things like, I have an air purifier in the room, right over on the other side, but you get this type noise. So I'd have to turn it off. Backup drives, just the mechanical spinning disc, you get a little bit of the, I'd have to turn them off, it'd pick them up as well. I had a power conditioning unit that plugs into some of the rack gear. It'd even pick up that. It's a bit of a nightmare, to be honest. The lights that I use to make me look lovely for you, they have fans built in. Can't turn them off. So there was always this hiss in videos, on top of the fact that the Tascam 60D Mark II, as useful as it is actually a little shitty. I don't think it's great. It does a job and it's okay, don't get me wrong, but it's not like top quality. So that's a little bit hissy. Into the preamp of the camera, which can be a little bit hissy. So you can see where I'm going with this. It was a consistent problem all the time. And some people have commented on some of my videos saying, it's a bit hissy. And I'm like, yeah, no. So I tried all different types of gain staging to get rid of this problem. And I got something I was happy with. I think the past few videos has been okay. I'm pretty happy with that. However, then I stumbled across something which I thought was mind-blowing. And that is this little box. Now, in this box, I have DJI Mic 2s. Let's see if I can get them to focus. The DJI Mic 2. Now, I'm actually wearing one just out of camera. There it is. So, these are wireless lavs, essentially. But here's the super cool thing about all of this. So you get the little charging case, which holds the receiver, two lavs and a receiver. So if I'm doing interviews or anything like that, I now have two channels. They've got a range of like 250 meters, which is ridiculous. They've got active noise cancellation, which is one of the biggest things for me, because now the is just completely silent. Delicious. It means I can leave the aircon machine on, I can leave the drives on, I don't have to worry about hissing sounds. The quality of them is absolutely, well, I mean, you're listening to them now, they're great, right? I think really, really nice cinematic almost quality. But the best part is I bought a DJI adapter, camera adapter. Now, let me just take my iPhone and I'll shoot you a little video of this so you can see what I'm talking about. So the DJI mic adapter, basically, it connects into the hot shoe of the camera. Now the Sony A7 IV, which is why I shoot on, has a digital hot shoe. What this means is once you've connected to the receiver to the adapter, it will feed 48K 24-bit 2-channel audio straight into the camera, bypassing the preamp, which is an absolute godsend, because the preamp, as aforementioned, is shit. So now we can just bypass that and record straight digital audio. This is good times. It means that I don't have to worry about any of that hissing business. Super easy. I just snap the thing on the top of the camera, slide it in the hot shoe. I'm ready to go. I've also got adapters with this DJI mic kit for USB-C. And I've also got lightning adapters. So if I wanted to shoot with an iPhone, let's say. God damn it, focus. If I wanted to shoot with an iPhone, focus. There you go. If I wanted to shoot with an iPhone, I can do that. Or a USB-C device, whatever that may be, I can do that as well. This case that it comes in, it's an active charging case. So, as long as I keep this case charged, the whole thing is always charged. Amazing for location shooting. You also get this delightful overnight bag. And inside there, that opens up to give you a couple of windscreens, which I've not opened yet, obviously, if you want to do some outdoor shooting. And it also gives you a USB-C cable, USB-C to A. Thanks, DJI. Most people go C to C and it can be quite annoying. And lastly, a standard 3.5mm jack, just in case you want to raw dog it old school with a jack connection, can do that as well. This is just incredible. This whole kit was like £300 or something like that. My only... See, I say there's a negative to it, but... If I had to pick out a negative so far, it's the weight of them. Like, Jesus Christ, they're a little bit heavy. Well, that's because they've got, you know, I don't know if you can see in there if I focus at all, but they're full of chips and technology. They've also got built-in memory on board, so you can actually record direct onto one of these, plug them in via USB-C and take the audio off it later. So you actually have a external recorder as well, so you can record a backup track on this, or if your camera shits the bed and stops recording audio, you can record it straight on here. They're so handy, they've really thought of everything. The weight is a bit concerning, but I'll figure out a way to deal with that. So on the back you have your standard clip clipping it to things, or they've even thought of this. Ooh, a satisfying snap. Magnets, so now you can attach them to dresses, curtains, like if you're going to put them on location, you want to hide them, you can, you know, attach them to the visor in your car, like, there's so many options with them. Oh, another cool thing, they have a 3.5mm jack in the top, so if you want to actually plug a lav in, you can do that, and they'll take a 3.5mm jack for a lav connection, which again, DJI have thought of everything. These are just great devices, and as I say, you're hearing them now, so win-win. Aside that way, I'm going to have to figure out a way to do this better, because I keep looking like someone trying to pull my shirt off, but that's what you get for wearing t-shirts that are too big, I'm afraid. You get the loose neck problem. I'll do better next time. Anyway, that's enough tech ranting for this morning. I just felt like I had to share these with the world. And the thing is, all these other microphones and preamps and bits of stuff I've got, they will be coming to an auction site near you sometime soon, because frankly, I don't need them anymore. Anyway, have a blessed day, and until we meet again, be well.